main body of works that is displayed in the show is triggered by a memory of a place that I was born from and where I belong to. I belong to Kerala. I am from Kochi. Place is actually situated in Ennagiri. And it used to be a place which had a long, big paddy fields. My people used to work there in the fields as agricultural laborers. And most of the houses are situated between these fields. It is owned by the landlord there who had this all the land which covered all these fields. And it's like acres and acres of land. It has a river and many many small ponds that they make for agriculture purposes. And it is actually a settlement of these people who actually work as farm laborers during that time, and which I also belong to a later generation of that people. Now, like, because of the city that is growing, you know, what a Kochi city, the place is also becoming, also changing its time. Now, there is no farming happening there, and you know, people are buying land from people. The land prices have gone up. So the lands are like arid lands, which are like with wild vegetation and water and all these things. And these people still, there is a considerable amount of people living there. Most of them are already displaced, like selling the land, and they've gone somewhere actually. So this is the place that I'm actually trying to talk about where I belong to, about. And people who live there, they have their own thinking, stories and all these things belonging to that place, and their customs and their beliefs. So such kind of thing actually triggered my imagination on this body of work. Being a certain oppressed person actually means, or belonging to a Dalit community actually means something that they don't want to talk about or tell to the younger generation that belongs to them. They don't want their children to be so pathetic as they had, the poverty and all these things they had to deal with. So they willfully kind of forget the past they are going through. So I think that's the main reason, like, they are not ready to talk about or, and it's also because of this people who are displaced from that place, and they try to belong to another community, or they get jobs and they move by, and they never actually initiate a talk about what they were and what like kind of life they actually lead. And partly maybe because of the modern education also, like their knowledge is never considered some kind of. The later generation, all of them are that education actually kind of alienates these indigenous knowledges from people which can be understood by the later generation. So there is actually literally a gap between that phase. So, and I belong to that later generation who had education, who actually got displaced from that place and I was living in another place. And I only visit a very short span of time. The conversations are very less, or confrontations are very less. This kind of dilemma is something that I am trying to deal with. Like, this kind of two-three layered kind of mind position that I have. Like, this is something that you hear as a child, and somewhere. And, actually, the formation for me also happened very really late after me growing up, and after realizing where I come from, or that such kind of inquiry, I actually pick up these questions of where my thinking comes from, or why do I think like this, or what are my concerns based on. So only at that point I realized that there are certain things that actually is responsible for why I am like this. So the identification, as I said, happened really in a later stage to me. So maybe that actually triggered. And as far as memory or these stories are concerned, people don't know them anymore. Like the only maybe the older generations and the older people know them. So it's very fragmented versus mixture. Only a person like me, after maybe can make certain associations between all these things and make it as a continuous. Documentation also happens in this kind of memories. Like you always have growing up, there are certain stories that you heard in the childhood, and after that process of myself, it is kind of an association that I make that actually make these memories meaningful for me. Illustrations are something that I was exposed to as in through books and all these things since my childhood, as you know, as images and all. So it has that. I think it has that influence on me, like about seeing an image rather than seeing paintings or any other kind of things, like these magazines and these children's books and these television images, and all these have this graphical illustrated quality in them. And this is something I was exposed to as a kid, and I wanted to be an animator. Started, like I wanted to go into animation, so, and I was a cartoon fan, so all these things added up to a certain extent of the way you see things and the images that you are exposed to, paintings and all these things. So it was after like completing my masters and after initially like when I was doing my bachelor's work, I had these influences of this illustrations and graphic elements initially, but slowly I lost it in the process of time. Like in the first few works we can see certain exaggerated features which is roughly alienated from the figure but just made for the aspect of making them caricatures or something like that. But after a certain point of time that changes. And it actually comes back maybe after my master's, after working as an illustrator and comic book artist for certain time. Actually, I was kind of able to relate myself to that language for a certain extent. And you know, these two combinations happen. I think that in that way, I have a different take on that language. That all in all, these are all languages of visual things. There are ways to say certain things. Like, there are ways to narrate a certain story, there are ways to say certain things. There are, like, in painting also, the application of paint and all, and the surface and the way you make an image. So, I was trying to like take these two languages and make it more meaningful for me to a certain extent. Like painting as painting and just bringing in some elements of these popular elements into that, or certain aspects of ways of saying the same thing, or certain aspects of making characters, certain aspects of making plots, or even the camera angles and certain aspects of cinema also. Because I also did some storyboards for film. And I think for me it's sort of this visual that is that you are exposed to, and even every one of us is exposed to this camera way of seeing and this the other way of seeing things, because everywhere you actually see all these things. Like you are exposed more to this rather than you see a painting. Maybe that helped me to a certain way to, you know, rejuvenate my language of paintings to a certain extent, to give me a certain gave me a different way to say things or to see things in a different manner. As a child, I used to go to these Sunday classes for learning to paint. So they always had the habit of taking very little bit color, and we were meant to copy this master's works. So this habit, I actually had this habit in me. So even after getting into fine arts, I always had this inability to pick color or be free with it for a certain extent. So I'll be stuck with certain options of using the color in a certain manner, like certain color should not be used in certain things. So I started using color, like very bright colors in my room. Like in the initial starting stages, I was using, and it also has the influence of certain things I saw, maybe some print or some media kind of images that I like, basically cartoons or kind of popular images that I was exposed to. They all had this bright colors in them. I think that color is always a relative thing. It's always in the relative process that a color gets a meaning or it is understood in a certain way, or it gets the significance that it needs. And I understood that fact, like color as such has nothing to do with itself. Like it just kind of it's always that context or that relative where it is kept that makes meanings inside that. Actually, that was something that I could then actually break out of that problem of color that I had. I could use it in a certain way that I had. Trying to give importance to lines and more graphic element more rather than color to a certain extent. And that, you know, the way you use it, certain things at certain prominence, like, you know, color was actually. To a certain extent was that kind of process, to be use it in more minimal or kind of restrained manner, so it doesn't influence certain other aspects of the work that you want to see. It kind of pulls in lot of meanings that you don't want to, maybe in this body of work I didn't want to say so much things. I wanted to be. And I thought by adding, like in this work you can see some colors here and there. So that those are very specifically defined to stay to a certain aspect only, like the red color. So you can see blue color in that black and white coat. And that is also very specifically, you know, like put in a place that obviously it can be sky or anything like that. So I didn't want it to actually, you know, a lot of things to come in and make this thing more confused or, you know, like get out of my hand after a certain time. Actually, using color, I always felt that problem inside me a lot. Like, you know, sometimes what you want to say just gets pretty much carried away with certain aspects of bringing in color. And it's also a process as far as I am concerned. I am not saying that it's kind of statement that I'm trying to make or kind of symbol or kind of a thing that I will always do, but it's a rather a process of mine to understand how this kind of things works and even how to understand this more better.